Uganda's envisaged oil investments to the tune of $22 billion is an opportunity ready for transporters, but they must move at the same pace with the logistics industry trends.
I have traveled and visited ports, and I've seen the work that goes on, and I've noted the change that has happened, where you have paperless work moving on, and things are moving very fast. So that's why I'm saying we need to keep with the trend and the dynamics, the changing dynamics that were also ever changing.
The minister was speaking at the Regional Logistics Expo in Kampala today.
Then there is the support infrastructure. The support infrastructure. Before I, on the pipeline, think about it, there will be a coating plant. Coat the pipes, because when they come here, they will be painted to stop being rusted. So that plant is almost as big as the central processing facility. This pipeline is going to go through 11 districts in Uganda.
And observers say structural improvements in critical areas of the logistics industry are needed to improve doing business.
The key logistics players need to embrace the use of ICT in freight logistics to be more efficient, whereas in government, particularly URA and other government agencies are moving very fast on this. We see slow progress from the private sector. For example, when we are talking about the doing business indicators for Uganda or Uganda's logistics index globally, we are not doing very well. Some of the key challenges that affect Uganda's rating are the ease to export, the ease to get containers to export, and how efficient we are as a country.